Now today we are going to complete remaining question of the exercise 6.5. So let's continue with the remaining question, that is first 23. That is one of the important question. Now here, prove that the volume of the largest cone that can be inscribed in a sphere of radius capital R is 8 by 27 of volume of a sphere. So here two things are to be discussed here. First of all, volume of the sphere, and secondly, volume of the cone. And these two are to be linked with each other as a coefficient 8 by 27. So first of all, a sphere is available with the capital R radius, and inside that sphere we have to form a cone. So let's try to understand what the diagram it will be. This is a spherical. Now under this, inside this sphere we are having a cone. This you can take as a radius with capital R. You just make it consider as a this is a center. From here, height of the cone you can describe. This is your base of a cone. Take this base of a cone as a radius small r. This is A, B, C, center with this O. This point you can consider as M. Now from here to here it is being a radius, so this will be considered as a r. From here to here again it will be considered as a radius of a sphere. Let the height of the cone be small h. This is a height of a cone. Now first we write volume of a sphere, and then we discuss about volume of a cone, and then at last we try to make them link with each other. So first of all, we will talk about volume of a sphere V1. That we know that 4 upon 3 pi r cube. This we mark as a first equation form. Now secondly, we talk about a triangle form over here, which will helpful to you to find out the one parameter in form of other. So here we will talk about, let radius of base for cone is small r with height small h. Now here in this one triangle we are going to frame here, that is AMO. It is being a height, so Pythagoras you can implement over here. So in your triangle AMO, your measurement of angle AMO is your 90 degree. Now Pythagoras you can implement here, but this side here we have not defined separately, so we can think about this side what it would be. Height means your MC is total H, your OC is available as R. So if you are going to find out this height, it will give you H minus R. So here one thing we can define, that CM is your H, whereas OC is your R. So from the diagram, OM you can write as CM minus OC, that means H minus R. So we can define the height of, or you can say the altitude of this triangle as H minus R. Now in this triangle you can implement your Pythagoras. So now further in triangle AMO, what you will get? R square is equal to small r square plus h minus capital R whole square. Make it sort out for some more solution. So make it expand. R square will give you R square plus h square minus 2hr plus R square. Here R square will cut. From here R square we are going to make it separate out. So small r square, here you will get it as 2hr minus h square. This is a one relation you have derived over here. Means r square you can write in terms of h. Now next we move towards the volume of a cone that we are going to be laying. So here volume of a cone, that we can take it as a V, 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Now here this r square we will replace by using equation second. So using equation 2, that will give you 1 upon 3 pi r square, that means 2 h r minus h square into h. Make this h, multiply inside the bracket. This will give you 2r h square minus h cube. That is your V2. Here you can see r is being a radius of a sphere, so it is being a constant quantity. Pi is also a constant quantity. So h is being a variable, means height of the cone. As per the position of the base, the height will be change of the cone. So this is a variable. So this whole term convert in form of a function of h. So it can be further treated as a function in form of h for better handling. Now it is to be differentiated for maxima and minima evaluation. So differentiate it with respect to h. This will be f dash h, pi by 3 keep as a constant. Now here h is a variable, so this will give you 2r into twice of h minus 3h square. Now this will give you pi by 3, 4rh minus 3h square. Proceed for second derivation, because that will also be required, and before that it will be better we find the h solution in terms of r for maxima and minima. So the next step is, for maxima and minima, f dash h, put it 0. On putting this first derivative as a 0, what will you have? Pi upon 3. 4rh minus 3h square is equal to 0. This is a non-zero quantity. So 4rh minus 3h square will be 0. H is to be taken common. 4r minus 3h is equal to 0. H is a non-zero quantity. So this 4r minus 3h you will put as 0. So 3h will give you 4r, and finally h will coming out as 4r upon 3. So for this height you will talk about the maxima and minima evaluation. Now we will proceed for second derivative and check it, the maxima is going to be take place or minima volume it going to be take place. So as f dash x was pi upon 3, 4rh minus 3h square. Further make it differentiate with respect to h. So f double dash h will give you, solution is 4r, h is to be differentiated, so it will give you 6 of h. Now h already you have evaluated in terms of r, so go for substitution there and check it out, it's a sine. This is 4r minus 6 into 4r upon 3. This will be cut twice. This is pi by 3. 4R minus 8R. So finally here you are having minus 4R pi upon 3, means it is being a negative quantity. Now being f double dash h as a negative quantity at this derived h value, that means the volume of the cone will be maxima at this evaluated h value. So now we will put a comment over here. That is, volume of a cone is maximum at h is equal to 4r upon 3. So we conclude about that. Now we have to link volume of the cone with the volume of the cylinder at this derived height. So let V2, it was pi upon 3, 2 h square r minus h cube. Now this whole relation we will convert in form of volume of sphere, means this formula we have to derive over here. Now substitute h as 4r upon 3. So this is 2r already available. 4r upon 3 square minus 4r upon 3 cube. Make it sort out. This is pi by 3. 2r into 4 square 16. R square upon 9 minus 4 cube means 64. R cube by 27. Here everywhere you can see your r cube is common. So first you make them multiply. This will give you 32 upon 9 r cube minus 64 upon 27 r cube. R cube you can take common, pi by 3 as such. Now 27 you go for taking as a LCM. So 3 into 32 will give you 96 minus 64. So this is your pi by 3 r cube. What is left with you? 32 upon 27. Now what we have to link this volume of a cone with the volume of a sphere? This is 8 by 27 multiple of volume of a sphere. So make it sort out accordingly. This 32 means 8 into 4. So this also we make it split as 8 into 4 by 27. Now try to arrange this whole 8 by 27, keep it outside. Secondly, this 4 pi by 3 and r cube you keep together. This is what volume of a sphere what we have defined in the beginning. So this will be the volume of a sphere as a V1. So 8 by 27 of V1. So what the relation we have derived? That V2 is a 8 by 27 of V1, means volume of a cone is 8 by 27 times of volume of a sphere. And because of this interconversion, this question is in most important question form. Here two things we have to discuss. First, derivation of this h, and secondly, at this particular h, interrelation in between the two derived volume form. Now next we are going to move question 25, that is also important one. In 25, again we have to discuss about the cone and its volume form. Now in 25th, first of all try to understand what the question is. In 25th, show that the semi-vertical angle of a cone of the maximum volume and of given slant height is this much. So what is the meaning of the question? We try to understand. Here one cone is available with given slant height. Slant height and height of the cone, you all are clear about. This is the base of a cone with radius r. Semi-vertical, this whole angle consider as a vertical angle, and semi-vertical angle, that means this angle you will take it as a theta form. The whole angle you will consider as a 2 theta, and if the whole angle you consider as a theta, it will be your half. So that particular angle we are going to discuss here. Height of the cone is h, whereas slant height that is available to you means it is a fixed quantity that we normally consider as a L. So one relation everybody is clear in terms of L, H and R is a in cone, L square is equal to H square plus R square using the Pythagoras theorem. So whenever it will be required, we will use it. Now here what is being talked about, that for a given slant height, you will talk about the volume of a cone with a maximum solution. So that we will discuss about. So here we will describe volume of a cone, that we know V is equal to 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Now here this r square you can replace by using this relation in form of L and H, because H is available, H will separate out, L is being constant quantity, so your function will turn in form of H there. So from here R square you can write as L square minus H square. Go for substitution there, pi by 3. In place of R square, L square minus H square into H. This is V only, pi by 3. Make them multiply inside the bracket. So finally, the whole combination will turn in form of a variable h, whereas your L is being a constant given quantity. Now, this can be expressed as a function in form of h, which is available for the first derivation and evaluation of value of h in terms of L. So here, differentiate with respect to h. So that will be f dash h pi upon 3 L square minus 3 h square. Now here we will find out the relation in between L and h on putting this first derivative 0. So for maxima or minima, everywhere your process is being same, you can notice also. So what you will find over here, pi by 3 L square minus 3 H square is being 0. This is a non-zero quantity. So this expression you will put as a 0. So 3 H square is your L square. So H you can say as a L by under root 3. So whenever it will be required to us, we will use it. Now we will proceed about the second derivation. So here S f dash x was pi upon 3 L square minus 3 h square. Differentiate with respect to h. F double dash h means pi by 3, it will give you 0 minus 6 h. Make it sort out, that will cut. So minus 2 pi into h. This is L by under root 3. You can see the whole quantity is being a negative quantity. Your second derivative is being a negative quantity. That means S f double dash h is being a negative quantity. That means your volume is maxima at h is equal to L by under root 3, or you can say is equal to else. Whenever it will be required, you can use as an interrelation in between. Now, our main purpose was to find out this semi-vertical angle. So, from this triangle, you can define this angle in form of tangent, because answer is being asked in form of tangent only. That's why. So, now, in your triangle AOB, tan theta means R upon H. R you can write as a square root of, another way also it can be defined, upon H. L what it was? Under root 3H. So here go for substitution. This will give you 3H square minus H square. Inside the square root, this is H. What will you have here? 2H square square root upon H. Means under root 2H upon H, HH cut. Finally, we will left with under root 2. So final answer, you can write it down is, tan theta is under root 2. So theta will be separate out as tan inverse under root 2. So this way, this semi-vertical angle will be separate out. In this case, it may be asked to use sine. So you can write the sine angle also as a answer form. So this is also one of the important form which can be asked to you in the exam. Here one thing is common, that process of evolution is common everywhere. Now we move to the next question, 26, that is also based on evolution of this semi-vertical angle, but another form is being asked here. Now the next question we are going to discuss is question number 26, in which you have to show that semi-vertical angle of right circular cone of given surface area and maximum volume is this much. So again, theta is to be described for volume maximum and given surface area. So here you can see the conditions are different, but the evolution is the same. So let's start with the given parameters. Here first of all, surface area is being given. So it is again a cone. With height h. Radius r. Slant height l. This is your semi-vertical angle, but its derivation is changed. Now what is the ability that surface area of the cone is given? So let's start with the same. Here also the same relation you will use whenever it will be required. L square is equal to H square plus R square. So whatever the form it will be required, you can use it. Now what is given to us? Surface area, that is S. Surface area of the cone is what? Pi r l plus pi r square. Now from here we are going to make separation of l, because s is being a fixed quantity. So we will convert the whole question in form of r. So first of all, from here pi r we can take it common. S upon pi r, that will be l plus r. From here l is to be separate out as S upon pi r minus r. So this way your L will be separate out. Now we talk about the volume. It was the surface area. Now volume of a cone V 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Here this L is to be substituted, and this whole expression is written with the R variable. Now here, this R variable is to be kept as such, so this H is to be replaced. So in order to that, first of all, make them square. So on squaring, V square will be 1 upon 9 pi square R 4 H square. Now from the beginning, H square we can write is L square minus R square. So that we will substitute here. 1 upon 9 pi square R power 4 L square minus R square. Now this L we will substitute by using this first relation. So using equation first. So this is your V square pi square upon 9 R power 4 L. L that means what? S upon pi R. This is the main part of this question. After solving this part, you can handle it easily. Minus R square. Make it expand. Pi square upon 9 I power 4. Now the whole question turn in form of R, so it can be treated as a function in form of R in place of V square. Now make it expand. S square upon pi square R square. Middle term 2 S pi R into R plus R square minus R square. These two will be cut. This is pi square I R 4 upon 9. S square pi square R square minus, from here RR will also cut, 2S upon pi. Now here, first of all, S we are going to take common, and secondly this pi square and R square we are going to make it insert inside the bracket. So this will give you S we have taken common, so S upon 9, then S pi square R 4 upon pi square R square. Here also the same S we have taken common. So this is 2 pi square R 4 upon pi. Make the cancellation of term. You will be free for handling this situation. This is cut. This is also R square. So it is S R square minus this pi pi cut. So this is 2 pi R power 4. Now this function is available for first derivation. It was F R. Now you can handle the situation very well. Now differentiate with respect to R here. F dash R, that will give you S upon 9, 2 S R minus 8 pi R cube. Now for maxima or minima, F dash R is 0. Means S upon 9 2 SR minus 8 pi R cube will turns to 0. This is 2 SR is equal to 8 pi R cube. From here you can see this is cut here. 4s are, this will give you R square. So here this will give you S upon 4 pi S a R square, or you can say R is under root S by pi 1 by 2. For this R we will talk about the plus or minus sign. So next to that, S it will be required afterwards, so we will make it put here. Now if you will go for the second derivative, you will have 2s minus 24 pi r square. On substitution of r square over here, you will find this is a negative quantity. At r square is equal to S upon 4 pi, you will get it as a negative quantity. Go for substitution, definitely you will have. That means at R is equal to under root S upon 2 under root pi, volume is maximum. Now we will talk about the sin theta. Now the surface area S, that is pi r l plus pi r square. From here you can say that S is equal to 4 pi r square. This you can treat as a second equation. Now here, using equation 2, this will give you 4 pi r square pi r l plus pi r square. Shifting towards that side, 3 pi square pi r l, pi pi cut, 1 r also cut. So 3 r you are getting as l, means r by l you are getting as 1 by 3. Now sine we have to define. So sine theta you will have as r by l, that means 1 upon 3. So theta you will evaluate as sine inverse 1 upon 3. So this way your angle will be coming out. Thank you.